Chris Maylett for BBTV, video in association with Trident Sports and Anthony's Travel. I'm pleased to say I'm joined by Mike Jackson, assistant coach down here at Hatton's gym. Good to see you, mate. How's it going?
You as well.
just come down this morning to watch all the lads train and have a word with him. And obviously you're here, ever present in the gym.
You've done well to get through the snow, didn't you?
As usual, mate.
Doing well to get through the snow.
I battled the snow as well, yeah. So, So, what's been happening, Mike? What's the camp's always busy, and we were saying
you're all over
the show as well, aren't you? Travelling about with everyone.
Well, Jake, who we've just weighed, boxed in Bury on Kieran's show week before last. Weekend just gone was at the York Hall with Nathan, won in the second. This weekend we're in Dublin for Chris Blaney. The week after we're going down to London for sparring with Lucas Brown, who's fighting Dylan White. The week after that, Jake's fighting in Stoke. And I think we get a bit of a break now for a couple of weeks.
Do you like travelling though? Do you enjoy it?
The year's flying. It's the way it be. Yeah. No. When you've got a date to aim for and you can set the schedule out, they all know what they're doing and we know where we're at. And just organise a sparring and market.
You started off at the College of Moston years ago with Brian Hughes. You had all them lads there and boxing all over the world, and you travelled everywhere, so you're certainly used to it, aren't you? And
yeah, we had even more. I mean, we've got five or six here. Back then we had about 14. So the way we used to work, that was who was fighting next, they got priority. And everyone used to help them. We used to spar each other. Different ways didn't matter, and it were good.
Yeah. But you're enjoying it, Mike? You're enjoying your job
great.
And life and what you're doing, working here with Ricky? How does that go? It's obviously it's a great camp, but
I've said it before in interviews. He's a good trainer because of his experience of what he did, what he didn't do. If any of our lads did what he did in between fights, I don't think they'd be here. But as Rick's got a saying, do as I say, not as I do. And he's right. You learn from your own mistakes, but you learn from other people's mistakes as well.
So. You've done obviously Brian Hughes, like we just said, you've done a lot of learning there. Now you're with Ricky and all the experience he had in the ring. And are you always picking up yourself, Mike? And do you feel you're becoming a better coach yourself as the years have gone on? And
Well, you like to think so. I mean, I think the problem people have is if they think they've cracked it. There's always something, around the corner, improve. Like, we got the heart monitors in here now, so that adjusts to the heart rate. It's all above my head, if I'm honest, Chris, but I can see the results in the gym. And I know that if they're in the red band, they work in full pelt. But these monitors, they make it harder to reach the red zone. So you're getting fitter. And then if they go for a run at night, the readout's coming out on Blaine's phone. So we know they've done the run, but we know how they've done on the run. And we're not even there, we're at home. It's just the technology. If you'd have tried explaining what I know now, 15 years ago, I'd just say, oh, go away. But you've got to move on. I'm a bit of a dinosaur, but for me, water, you can't go wrong with water, because a lot of these newfangled things, you've got to mix with water. But it's a science, isn't it?
And obviously Ricky has got a lot of hands-on experience in his career, to the highest level to pass on. What are Ricky's strengths as a coach, and having worked alongside him now for all these years? What is it that makes him tick as a coach?
Well, it's all the little tricks inside, especially because he was quite short and he was strong. All that stuff you do inside, he's a brilliant coach at that. But the fact that he's well aware that they're all different, which is what's Brian drummed into me. What's good for you ain't good for him. So it's finding what your fighter's best suited for.
Talking of Brian Hughes, he had a street named after him recently in the area.
Yeah, I signed a petition for that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So a couple of years, but deserved.
Yeah, definitely. I know he's not been well recently as well, so wish him all the best. And
definitely, yeah.
There's a place where you put your teeth down there at the Colliers.
Yeah, I've got so many brilliant memories of travelling all over with him. I'm waiting for his book to come out because it'll be a good read.
Yeah, definitely. I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah.
So, this weekend, the Irish prize fighter, it's the last man standing, I believe
yeah.
it is, and you're going over there with Chris Blaney.
Yeah.
He's been here now with you for a while. It looks like a good tournament. Has he got a good chance of prevailing in this, and Mike, in your opinion? Sure.
He's got a good chance, but it's a better lineup now than at the start because there's some pullouts, and the guys who have come in to replace, like Nick Quigley, Jack Cullen, who we've had here sparring many a time. It makes it very interesting, but if you ought to be the best, you've got to beat the best, and I'd rather him win a tournament with creditable opponents than people I didn't know much about. Mm-hmm. But he's knuckled down and he's done well.
Yeah, he's a good lad, isn't he? And he's unbeaten 9-0, so
he's had good sparring, his weight's been perfect, so we're really pleased with him.
And then we had a good win with the heavyweight Nathan Gorman as well at the weekend at the
People are saying, oh, he weren't much cop, but if you know what you're looking for, you know what you've been working on, we're absolutely delighted with that performance because he did what we wanted him to do. It's not the opponent, it's how you set about dismantling the opponent. And I thought from the first bell, he did what we asked and he knuckled down and he got the job done. It was very important that he had to impress because there's other people out there who are impressing and we've got to be better than them.
And it could be a big fight with the boy down the line as well. They were on the same bill, they're building it up to that. So if they both stay unbeaten, inevitably it will happen. It'd be a good one, that. But further down the line, maybe.
I mean, Dubois's opponent wasn't the best, but again, you got the job done, so that's all you can do. And people forget, these lads are only babies, they're learning. Nathan only had 12 amateur fights, he's only 21 years of age, so he's got a long way to go.
On that bill, Zelfa Barrett, who you know well, you've known him since he was a kid, Pat's nephew from the your old gym, the Colliers. He lost to Ronnie Clark. It was for the neutral, it was a really good fight. For anyone emotionally involved, it was very nice.
Just willing
him on. Included. But Zelfa can come back from it. He obviously shown many, many things about him in that. His character, his toughness, he could take a punch. But I think he'll learn an awful lot about himself after it. And I think he's admitted that already.
Yeah.
How do you see it yourself, Mike?
Well, I was up and down the stairs because we were next on, but what I saw, it was quite even until the knockdown in the six, which come out of the blue. But there was one point later on in the fight where Zelfa's gum shoe come out and he didn't look for biding time. He was like, come on. And that for me is a big box ticked. He's got heart. And I know Uncle Pat is not going to let that ride, is he? That'll be put right, and it'll be put right in the first fight back.
Yeah, right.
Valuable experience. Hard, but valuable experience.
Yeah, valuable, yeah. You can't buy that experience. Yeah. Oh, good to see you, Mike.
You as well.
Always good to catch up with you. Good luck in Dublin at the weekend.
Yeah.
Have a good trip, get the win.
Part Irish now, all the times we've been there.
Yeah, no, yeah, definitely.
All right.
Nice, great to see you, mate. All
you
the best. God bless you. See you again.
Bye. Bye-bye.